Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to BNN. Hi, guys. I know I've missed you. I've missed you so much. I know I gave you guys a scare last weekend, but I'm back now, and let's cover the news. So over the weekend, I covered a story asking my followers to tell me a secret, and it's always fun. I did it almost a week ago, and people said, give us part two, and it was pretty interesting. We had the usual sexual confessions, other people saying, I've slept with my cousin, I'm sleeping with my best friend's girlfriend, and all these crazy stories, which most of the people in my DMs were saying, in Nairobi, people are pretty idle, all they do is sleep around with each other, and Nairobi is one big bedroom. But there was this one confession that caught my eye. A girl came and confessed to something that her sponsor asked her to do, and this is what makes the entire topic for this video, because I feel this is a very important topic and it needs to be addressed, because I was surprised when I actually read this. A girl replied to my question saying, my sponsor wants us to try sex with a minor, which I feel I can't do it. LOL, I can't be that wicked. Me personally, I was quite shocked that this actually happens, and I actually replied back to this person asking, why exactly with a minor? They are so young and innocent and they know nothing about sex. And she responded saying that he wants to explore before he dies. I was personally quite disgusted at this, as in, who looks at a minor and sees anything sexual? I even went further to ask, now that she has turned him down, do you think that he will actually go and do this on his own? Then what she said next really put me back, as I was surprised that we actually have this kind of human beings walking around on this earth. She said the girl he was eyeing is in class 7 and that is a daughter to one of his close friends. She blocked him and cut all communication after he requested for this threesome with a minor. I was honestly quite scared at what this man is asking for. He's asking to have sex with a minor with someone who is in class 7. That girl is probably 12, 13 years old. And pay attention to exactly what he's asking. He's asking for you to do it with him. So this will implicate you as well in this crime. So by asking this, he's actually trapping you, and you will never be able to snitch on him, because you'd be also implicating yourself in this crime. And this is the exact same script R. Kelly used to pull. He would recruit girls and then ask these girls to recruit minors for him, and then he'd ask the girlfriends to sleep with the minor first before he touches them. He would probably sit in a corner and watch, or ask you to tape it, and then this is what he'll use to blackmail you, and then you can never ever speak up about it because you're also implicated in the crime. And this story actually just even got more crazy, as other girls came forward to me with the exact same story. This girl said she had had the same experience. Her sponsor wanted her to have a threesome with a minor, and his explanation was that young girls have a tight pussy. And I'm actually curious, do you have any doctors watching this? Can you tell us in the comments whether there's anything like a tight or loose pussy? She sent screenshots of their conversations where he's asking for the threesome and he clearly knows that it's illegal. He says, we can do something naughty and illegal. And then a third girl messaged me with the exact same story, saying that her sponsor also wanted a threesome with a minor. From the screenshots, I could tell that this is the exact same person from the profile picture and his name. She messaged me saying she thinks she knows this man, and in her experience, he wasn't asking for a threesome, but saying that he wants to fuck a young girl. He follows the exact same script, saying we should do something naughty and illegal. I want us to fuck a young girl. In the WhatsApp screenshots, he also goes on to clarify how old he wants them, saying that he wants them below 18. And this particular girl that she was messaging cautioned him against it, saying that those girls are too young for him. At this point, my blood was literally boiling. I asked this girl whether they were still together, but she said they are not together. After he started these weird ways, she cut all communication and blocked him. And when I asked her, should I expose this person, she said no. And I was honestly very pissed off. Why should I protect a pedophile? I don't think you guys understand how hard my job actually is. When I actually try to expose these cheaters, pedophiles, thieves, scammers, they all try to sue me or kill me. I always ask myself, how is it possible that these deplorable people can use the law to protect themselves? Doesn't that just sound crazy to you? I would personally love to expose this person, but the girls involved are not interested in that, as they fear for their safety. But I wonder, what exactly am I supposed to do? If I try to expose him, he will sue me or try to go after my life. It doesn't even matter that I have WhatsApp conversations between him and 4 different girls, admitting that he wants to have sex with a 14-year-old girl. And even more ironical is, if I expose him, celebrities will come to his defense saying, oh, Edgar doesn't know how to mind his business. Oh, Edgar just breaking up families. Oh, you all disgust me. So the third girl talked to me and explained further why she doesn't want to expose him, saying that she actually reached out to one of his girlfriends who was about to go through with this sleeping with a minor, and she convinced her not to. So she decided to protect him because she thinks that this man did not actually do it. So do you guys actually believe her? Do you actually think this man did not go through with this or has never done this before? I have reports that he is in late 60s and he is known as a community sponsor. And even worse is that he is married but has no children. So do you guys think that the wife knows exactly what this man actually does? Then a fourth girl actually came forward to me with the exact same story, telling me that he had introduced her to 5 different girls to have threesomes, and the last one was a minor in class 7. I literally felt like my heart broke at this point. I asked the fourth girl how these two even ever met, and she said a friend of hers introduced them. When she was 16, she used to send him pictures in exchange for money, and then some years later they matched on Tinder last year on January, and he couldn't even remember her. So this begs the question, how many girls is he exactly doing this with? And from the story I've just told you guys, here's what we know. This guy has prepositioned 4 different women to have sex with a minor. Are we supposed to believe that he's never actually done this? What makes a man interested in sleeping with someone who is 14, 13? Like, what the fuck? And then, even to make it worse, this is a girl that is actually his daughter's friend. So people are just this evil. So this video is just to educate all girls in Nairobi. Please leave alone these sponsors. They will actually get into you into shit. They're into some very, very weird things, like this man saying that he wants to try something new before he dies. He wants to have sex with a child. What the fuck is wrong with you? And for all the parents out there, please protect your children. If your child's name is Lucy, please keep her inside. They are very dangerous men wanting to have sex with your daughter. So thank you guys for all the support. After my little scare last week on Friday, I'm okay now. I think they got scared and they backed off. And that's the day I realized that there's actually a lot of power in social media. A lot of you came to my aid. A lot of you people who work in very, very important jobs in this country, having my back and making sure that I'm safe. Thank you all. Anyway, guys, that's all from me. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.